This part is for the front bodice. I'm going to fold that into half and mark out my markings. It's just absolutely centered, and here I'm going to take the shoulder measurements. The shoulder measurement is approximately 16 inches, half inch for your seam allowance. So the armhole length should be about 7 to 7.5 inches, which is what I've marked it off. And then depending on the bust size, for our sake, we're going to work on a 40 inch bust, and on the waist we're going to work on 9, 18, 18, 36. I am going to dart this slightly, so this will give it the fuller figure, and that will also take it in just to on top of the bust point. So I've left this 9 inches. Here I've left it 40 inches, so this is a quarter of the 40. This is approximately 10 inches. And then it'll come in further with the dart of 2 inches, giving it a narrower waistline. We need the finished result of the waistline of about 30 inches. I'm not going to cut into the neckline, just mark it off. It's just going to be a round neckline. And basically that's just the shape of the top of the bodice. Slightly angled at the shoulder. I will put a couple of notchings here just to give just to define where my center point is. This is my center point, and then the distance between the two bust points would be about 7. I'm going to mark it off at 4.5 inches. That's going to be the center, and what I will do here is when I dart it, that will be the center of the dart, and when I dart this up, that distance, the dart would be about 1 inch, so that would leave me 3.5 inches in the center and 3.5 inches on that side, leaving it a total of 7 inches from bust point to bust point, which is basically what I'm looking at. So that is the, that doesn't look like it has much shape, but once it has the dart inserted and also the waistline taken in, that will look like more fitted, and you know, also the neckline being done. I will probably have to slightly trim it. I think it looks just a little bit wide on the shoulder, between the shoulder points. So I'm going to, these actually clothes are going to be worn by some teenage girls for a modeling a school project, which I've actually opted to host on their behalf. I will post you the videos to the event so you can see for yourself. It's a teenage fashion event that's been organized by a local school, and they've come to me and I've actually assisted them in the garments. So, and then this is for the sleeves. It's going to be short sleeves. Before I cut into the sleeve, what you need to do is just pin these two together so that the one doesn't come out more than the other. Once you've pinned it into place, fold it over. Now, if you feel that you need to add a bit of a piece on because the armhole is not wide enough, for our sake, this is adequate. So starting off at the top and then working downwards, I'm slightly angling it out. That's our sleeve. Oof, it's impossible to cut the four because separate these and put them out individually. Now this piece of the fabric is actually for the rest of the, I've got to cut another one of these for the back. Now I've got fabric which is this, which I can cut it out of. Now if I'm going to cut it out of this fabric, I'm going to take away the piece for the, this piece was, is used on the bottom of the dress here. So it's going to be used on top of the seam, which is going to attach the two pieces of the bottom and the top. And then we're going to use this just to cover the two up. I have this piece of fabric that's left over, and I also have this piece of fabric that's left over. Now this is the fabric that I'm going to use to cut the back of the dress or the top bodice area. I'm going to line this in the lining fabric, which once I've cut into this, I will cut that also. I'm going to put a zip in at the back, so the two cut edges I'm going to use as that. Again, this I'm going to notch in the sort of distance of where I want the darts. So it's just a half, and I've notched it here just to make sure that I know where the center point is. So that's the two back pieces, that's the front piece, and then that's the sleeve. Now going back to the picture, I think what it's got is it's got the full net sleeves and then the other sleeves on top. So since we're going to follow that through exactly, we're going to cut the net sleeves out of this. Now the net sleeves are full sleeves, and what we have is these sleeves sort of go on top. So measure the length of your full sleeve, which should be approximately 21 inch to 23 inch. I'm going to do mine at approximately 23 inch. It's exactly the same cut as the other sleeve. Trim into that. We're going to narrow this down a little bit because we want a fairly fitted sleeve. So that's your full length of sleeves. This is a piece of fabric that's left over, and you can actually, if you wanted to use it, it's not really used anywhere else on the dress. So what we can do is we can take the silver trim off and use it around the neckline, which is something that I might consider doing. So I'm just going to trim it away and then perhaps use this on the trimming of the neckline. Now I haven't decided on the neckline that I'm going to do. Just work out, see if it's adequate to do it as a V. It's not always suitable to do a round neck